Several, even these machines that we use, sometimes they are in their period. That's actually a sexist statement to say. You can't make that joke. What was I talking about? But you're complaining to Jamaica. Zibante kayo. I've always complained, but I want to. Man, there's probably a woman who has just killed the husband and she's looking for a young boy. So, the boy looks like a locust. You know, but if they, when they want to, they reduce their nose. I have a huge nose. And people on Twitter these days are shameless. That's the only thing they tell me, say, you have a big nose. So, I want contour. We want contour. So, they want to take out. So, sometimes that's why you see, take out on air. Oh my God, this show is hopeless. So, the show is called, yeah, Reliable Analysis. My name is Tumusime. I'm always here weekdays. 8 up to 8:30 p.m. Today is Valentine's Eve. Mbwa yeah, men are dogs. Men are trash. Kali. Hey, statue. Before women kneel, we are not going to do anything. Men, it's time for us to exercise the patriarchy. Oh my God, bro. But that's a, you know what's actually funny? Feminists watch this show. I'm like a feminist friend who watches this show. And again, I'm like, how do you keep on watching this show? Because me, when I'm making jokes sometimes, I feel I've always believed that there's no topic that is above. Joking about maybe like rape or what, but these are the topics. Many what which have your patriots, many gender debates. Anyway, this is to be said. I'm also not that I'm uptight, but for some reason, I'm watching you. I feel like you just don't have brains, which is a misconception. I am a clever man. Say again, okay, that's the point, that's for debate. But today is Valentine's Eve, so men do not give in. I've been mobilizing since the week started. We need to make, because one of the worst things that we, a woman, that can happen to a woman is being lonely. Because women, it's just that nature will not accept it. Because women just want to be loved. Stay here. Eh? So you can blackmail her into anything. Because tomorrow she needs to take pictures of flowers and put on her status. Otherwise, a fabu fee. Stay here. So you can ask for anything. Tonight, close to midnight, 11, start the negotiations. You say that you want the side of the bed that is closed to the socket. For you poor people, for rich people, they have like 20 sockets, so they don't even know what to do with them. But for you poor people, Mulwa need a socket. And power banks. And who gets to. Okay, let me not continue. You can follow me on social media. That is Tumusime on Facebook and on YouTube. My God, everything is huge now. I just keep on checking in. It's like I don't know how many people follow per hour, not even per day. Like, but I'm eternally grateful. Instagram and Twitter at Tumusime UG. These days, I'm on Twitter a lot. It's better than watching pornography on Pornhub. So cutting the Twitter. So don't judge me. Don't think that I don't have anything to do. I'm in rehab. I'm in recovery. So we start on with men's conference. Men's conference 2020. This is a very okay, it's not going to be there, of course. But I heard that there's one in Kenya. I don't know if it's true or not, or it's just a social media hoax. I think here in Uganda, social media, just a social media talking point. But wouldn't that be great if we had a social a men's conference? You ever notice that there is no men's issue that can ever take precedence, you know? And women are tired because of three things. Men have a lot of, like 1% of men are in power. You know, like whenever sometimes I just see feminists talking, I'm like, Lord. Like feminists will come and say, oh my God, see, many men have too much power. What percentage of men are those? Out of the 6 billion men on earth, how many are really powerful? Hey, all men have the money in the world, women are poor. Okay. You know, I just don't know. Like I've already said, maybe I just need to work on my mindset. Like every other time, I'm always either getting a big opportunity or being hired by a well-paying job. It's always like a woman. So I think maybe, and my mother was a strong woman. Like I'm not trying to say that because of political correctness, and that's the right thing to say. But my mom was badass. She is still alive, but now she's old and she has mellowed, right? But she was a go-getter. Every day starting something, and then they've collapsed after 2 days. Then I inherited that. But anyway, Avora is like, the idea that women are not powerful has never really registered in my head. When I was in school, I was so bright. I know that's hard to believe. I was bright, you know? And I used to bed up to P6. So I was brilliant, but there's a girl, she's called Judith, I'll never forget her. She was like, oh my God, I used to get 86 in science. And I think, oh my God, she has 90. There's a time I got 91, she had 97, man. I'm like, is this what you are? And I'm a competitive man, it just doesn't show. So the whole idea has never existed in my head. So men's conference, we are going to go there and we talk about all these things that women, I wish it was there. Women are stepping on us, it's too much. Call us a dog and you want money.
call us trash, still you want us to be there for you. Men, we need some respect on our gender. And all this, the ringleader of this thing of abusing men is Winnie Byanyima. You just call Winnie Byanyima, you say the wife of Besigye, mama. She talks. Okay, Winnie Besigye is not necessarily, I mean, it's hard. He's one of those men that makes you lonely. Because half the time he's in jail. But still, come on, man. Winnie Byanyima. What's wrong with saying that? You know, Bebe Cool comes on and you're like, Bebe Cool, big size, the Bauer's winner. And you're like, wow. You know, of course, he says all because Wena is a beautiful woman. But if he was like one of these men who got excited and impregnated a girl when they were in a blackout in a bar and ended up marrying a Chimenke, she's like, Ungamba, Sigari Waka, baby, let me take care of you. So, men's conference, all I can say is that if there was ever be a men's conference right now, you would be surprised at how many issues that men face that are unanswered, you know? Very many. There's even a hashtag that is trying to trend, but it's failing. It's a trash called harassment against men. You know, like women don't know that a man can be harassed. You're like, do you know what you do? You know, sometimes I think they should put like a camera in the house and then women sit down and watch how they treat the man. You might be surprised if that ever leaked into the public. You'd be like, I'm a monster. Which is true. But, okay. Let's move on to Vero. So finally, there's a picture of locusts that's convincing. Those are locusts. Yeah, like also me, I can think those are locusts. Because they have been looking for them, you know. They said the locusts entered in Uganda and they couldn't find them. And Uganda, the whole talk was about locusts. Now, first of all, man, this makes us look bad, man. Like, locusts, should they dominate conversation like this? I'm just imagining if, like, I mean, some of these things, man, when you're talking about locusts, okay, you just say there are locusts somewhere. You send people to spray them. Then we keep on waiting for some important news. Like, if let's say there are nudes, Eddie Kenzo is bit about Rema, now raising a nude to Rema. I'm not saying that's what should happen. I'm just saying there's a lot of things that we could concentrate on. But you know, locusts are big. Locusts in Uganda, they have consumed the whole, you know, and I was seeing papers printing locusts. There are 20 species of locusts. The desert locusts, the alcoholic locusts, the locusts which have a lot of women. Then they start saying, do you know locusts have 7 stages? See, the pupa, the metamorphosis, the adult. Going to tell us the periods of locusts when they're in their peace? Jesus Christ. What? Oh my God. Let's go for a short break. We shall be right back. Don't go away.